You all right?
Uh-oh,
it's a flash. It's a nuclear flash. Remember they used to tell us that as kids?
Oh, my gosh.
What to do in the event of a nuclear flash?
Was that duck and cover?
That was part of duck and cover, but if you're out walking around, we boomers know all about this.
Oh, yeah.
When you're out walking around, they actually told us on these films. Do you remember they would have these people walking around and you would see this big flash of light somewhere?
Yeah.
What to do? And a lot of times it just involved finding the nearest house to go melt in.
Oh, my gosh.
But I don't know. Okay, well, I'm hoping it wasn't that. That was scary.
Happier things.
Like, check us out, by the way, boomersbraintrust.com. You can find this kind of segment, first five segments, guest segments. It's all there, boomersbraintrust.com. You can subscribe to the podcast, audio and video on demand. Come watch us, too, by the way, if you have a chance, boomersbraintrust.com.
Live? Right. In the audience?
That's our next step, is actually to have a live audience right here.
I heard they're building risers out there.
Yeah, we're working on that. We're working on that. All right. Unless you're slaving away behind an anchor desk every day, summertime means travel season is underway. Everybody's traveling except us.
Yep.
No, we're here for you. Traveling, though, should be relaxing. It should be fun.
Mm-hmm.
It's not always, but it should be. But if you aren't careful, by the way, it can be an identity theft nightmare. I don't know any other way to put it. The people at the Better Business Bureau are warning consumers to take precautions before heading out the door on vacation in order to keep identity thieves from spoiling your vacation this summer. Dinah has more, some tips, I guess, on how to survive this sort of thing. You wouldn't think you'd have to.
I know, and we talk about this subject, I realize, a lot. But the problem is, the problems aren't going away.
In fact, they're getting worse.
The number of people being taken or having their identity stolen just keeps growing by leaps and bounds. So we are going to keep talking about this until maybe something changes. I don't know. It's sad, but it's true that when consumers go on vacation, identity thieves, boy, they go to work. But a little preparation can go a long way toward making your trip a little more enjoyable, less stressful. The Better Business Bureau, they've come out with a list of tips to help avoid identity theft while you're away from home. Because, you know, when you think about it, vacationers, they're the ones who are typically carrying a lot more personally identifiable information with them.
Your passport sometimes, certainly all your identification, your
airline
credit cards,
tickets,
airline,
credit cards too. And likewise, they also typically travel with more money in their bank accounts, which of course makes them prime targets for criminals. So in an effort to curb some of that insidious activity, make sure you're not guilty of any of the following. All right, here we go again.
Number one.
Don't announce your travel plans on social media. I know this sounds like the broken record, but I see it all the time.
I do too.
It's people
at the airport.
Yes.
Hope I locked the house because no one's home. Heading out for 2 weeks. We'll return on July 16th.
And that's the thing. It's just it invites identity thieves to target your house while you're away. So turn off your location settings. Refrain from posting photos until you get back.
Someone might ask identity theft, but that would also, entail real actual theft.
People
walking into your home while you're not there.
Here's another one that people forget, and they forget until the last minute, and then they have to call neighbors. They're scrambling. Can you pick up my mail? When criminals see that a mailbox is overflowing, they figure it's an easy way to get some personal info, right?
And take your mail.
Right. And so, you know, likewise, you can have a neighbor pick up your newspapers, you know, put those on hold, whatever. Just make sure that there's no accumulation going on. And it would not hurt, by the way, to have some of your interior lights in your house set on automatic timers, you know.
I've done that.
It sounds lame, but anything you can do to give the impression that somebody's actually in the house, good thing.
In fact, on those automatic timers, have them change lights about every 3 seconds. You know what I mean? Just
and then have a voice call out, "You're wasting electricity."
Hey, you can't be too careful. I knew somebody that had one of those sewing dummies they put up in their window. Propped it up, put a drink in its hand, and played music. They still got broken into because the ice had melted in the drink.
There you go.
Whatever.
Here's one that's really important too, especially for we gals. Carry only the necessities in your wallet when you're traveling. Go through your wallet, leave your library card, leave everything else that has your name on it. You're not going to need it when you're traveling all over. You're not going to need your local library card. And it's a very good idea to bring as few credit cards as possible when you travel. Try to pick just one or two, because that keeps it just that much easier to stay on track of what you've charged already, and it makes it easier to reconcile with receipts and so on and so forth when you get back. So see if you can get it down to just one, maybe two. And here is the shout out to the ladies. Do yourself a favor, invest in a purse or some sort of pack for travel, something that's smaller, not so big, and then use it for several weeks before your trip so you're familiar with it. I just did that with my mom.
Good idea.
She's heading out on a big trip later. I'm not telling you where or when, but she's already acclimating herself to her new little purse. And they have really neat ones now that have the special material in it so that people can't scan it and get your credit cards. Have you heard
people
about that?
People doing that?
Oh, yeah. That happens all the time. That happens outside the grocery store down the road. But I mean, you definitely don't want to have that happen when you're away.
Yeah.
Also want to set up a travel alert on your credit card accounts and then freeze your credit with the three credit bureaus. Mm-hmm. Okay, this is going to prevent others from attempting to create new accounts while you're away because you may not be able to access. You won't be getting the notices from, say, if you have some sort of security system.
It's good stuff.
Also, if you can leave your laptop computer at home, please do. If you have to travel with a laptop, though, update all of your antivirus and anti-spyware programs and everything that you can. And here's something else to remember. Don't access bank accounts from your laptop while you're in a hotel room or at a coffee shop or any other place that has Wi-Fi, because that information can be lifted.
Mm-hmm. And it often is.
And of course, this sounds like a pain. It is a pain, and that's why you should just leave your laptop at home, all right? While staying at a hotel, use the in-room safe. That's where you should lock your important documents, like your passport and anything else that you don't want somebody making off with. And then also, use only ATMs that are actually in banks. If you bring a debit card with you, use it as a credit card, but try not to enter your PIN on unfamiliar devices, you know.
The one on the street, the one in the parking lot.
That
you
looks
know?
A little suspect.
There's one right there.
Oh,
yeah.
Oh, my gosh.
Yes. Misspelled AMT right there. This is for you. Yes.
You also want to protect your smartphone. If you are taking it with you, create a password for you to gain access to it. That way no one else can use it, or at least ideologically that will happen. Also use an application that has a GPS locator to find your phone if it's lost or stolen. And a lot of the phones now have those automatically built in. Mm-hmm. Don't put your full name and address on luggage tags. Just put your last name and your cell phone number. And the very final thing, shred, or at the very least, tear up and discard used boarding passes. This is something I am really guilty of. You know,
you keep your boarding. Well, you never
you
know.
Hang on to them, or you just throw them away, right? Yeah. But a lot of times, people will leave boarding passes behind in airplanes or at the airport or in hotels. And a lot of times, all your information is right on that sheet of paper.
Well, I thought
it's got your full name and so on and so forth.
Don't the airlines now, I only travel usually Southwest, where they just take the piece of paper that you printed at home or
sometimes,
the one you printed at the airport on your phone.
And Southwest also is the one that just started the new thing where you can just show yourself
your smartphone
and they can scan it and you don't have to worry about the actual paper.
Good. So they're wise to that.
Yes.
All right. Well, that's great stuff.
Well,
wow.
Thank you.
Hey, if you missed that, go to boomersbraintrust.com. You'll want to hear that again. Wonderful tips from Dinah Smith. We've got more advice coming up. Money Type with Professor Plum and the gang. 877-PLANNER is the number. PLANNER. We'll talk to them when the Boomers Brain Trust show continues.